Hello everyone, myself Vikrant Chandanshive. Today we are discussing about the construction of cDNA library. In our previous lectures, we studied how the cDNA will be synthesized by using mRNA as a template. So cDNA library. The cDNA library is a gene library containing only coding region of DNA without the introns. Introns is to be called as intermining sequences, which does not code for any kinds of amino acids or proteins. In a cDNA library, the collection of all genes present in a genome. This is one of the important aspects of the cDNA library. In human body, there are a number of genes present, and all those genes are find with the help of different techniques. We cannot find the whole gene, but we can find the mRNA which is to be expressed to such proteins. Okay, next steps of cDNA synthesis. First one is the extraction of mRNA. By using the different methods like chromatography techniques or the electrophoresis techniques, isolate the mRNA for the construction of cDNA. The mRNA, why we take mRNA instead of DNA? Because the mRNA does not contain any kinds of introns. That's why we take here the mRNA. Okay, next is what? Okay, we have now the mRNA. Then the next step is how the mRNA will be converted into cDNA. So the construction of cDNA. The cDNA is called as complementary DNA synthesized by the artificially using reverse transcriptase enzymes. Okay, that is a RNA dependent DNA polymerases. Most of the cases, the retroviruses contain such kinds of enzymes. Okay, so here see, here is a diagrammatic representation of cDNA library. So we are actually going to, okay, this is the structure of mRNA. Okay, this is structure of mRNA. mRNA can take 5 prime end and usually have the 5 prime end and the 3 prime end. Okay, usually have the 5 prime and 3 prime ends. So by using the reverse transcriptase enzymes, here we synthesize the double stranded cDNA. Okay, double stranded, all these DNA is a double stranded cDNA. Okay, so next stage is what? This cDNA, synthesized cDNA, will be ligated in a plasmid DNA. See here, this one is the our interested cDNA, okay? And this portion, show in the yellow color portion, this one is the our bacterial plasmid DNA, okay? So the thing is that when we have two ligate such a kinds of cDNA, we require some molecular scissors in which we can cleave this plasmid DNA. Okay, so here we have the one of the molecular tools, that is it is called as restriction enzymes, in shortcut it is called as RE. Okay, so there are near about 1 to 4 kinds of restriction enzymes is there, which help in construction of recombination, they mostly involves in a cutting and rejoining of DNA. Okay, so for the purpose of rejoining, here we use the ligase enzymes. So now we have, the cDNA associated with the plasmid, that is the, it is to be called as recombinant plasmids. Okay, which containing cDNA. So such a cDNA or such a plasmids now will be expressed in, the host DNA, that is nothing but the bacteria. Okay, bacteria here, our host is the bacteria. Okay, so in a bacteria, why we use the bacteria? Because the bacteria can divide 20 minutes. It have the doubling time is 20 minutes. Okay, that's why we select the bacteria. Okay, and See the how the bacteria when the bacteria divides multiple times, then simultaneously our recombinant plasmid is also divides and our cDNA is yet also divides. I means here from a single copy of cDNA we isolate the number of copies of our interested cDNA. Okay, so moving to our presentation. So this figure is just I explained. Next, construction of recombinant with the plasmids. The plasmid is the carrier of cDNA and contains specific sites for screening process. This is one of the important aspects in a selection process. That is, our interested cDNA is actually present in the plasmids, or it is expressed or not, how we can detect. By means, near to cDNA region, here we add some extra marker like light emitting marker or any color product marker. Okay, the cDNA is ligated to the plasmids and construction recombinant. Construction of cDNA library. In these steps, the recombinant express the cDNA in a host cell. The host cell multiply and forms more copies of cDNA. The replication of such interested cDNA in a large amount of gene collection. So that's why the cDNA is more important. Okay, thank you.